Today we're going to talk about the concept of expected value. What does it mean and why is it so important to the options market? Insurance companies are in part profitable because they take in more money from the insurance premiums that they sell than the claims that they pay out. You can think of the same thing for a casino. When you play a hand of blackjack, the house has a 51% chance of winning and you have a 49% chance of winning. That spread is the profitability of the casino. Over any individual hand, the chances are nearly 50-50, but over thousands and thousands and thousands of hands, the house comes out ahead. Think of the same concept for your options trading career. Over the long run, you want to be selling options for more premium than what they're worth at expiration. And you want to be buying options that are cheap, that are trading for less than what they're going to be worth at expiration. Over the long run, that's going to be your profitability. So what is expected value? Expected value is the sum of the probability-weighted outcomes. Think of a dice roll. A die has six sides, and there are six potential values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each one has a 16.6% chance of happening. If you roll a dice 1,000 times, the expected value of that dice roll is going to be 3.5, between 3 and between 4. And in the long run, it's going to equal 3.5. Now, let's take this dice example and make a casino game out of it. Imagine a casino comes to you and says, "Listen, I will pay you the face value of a dice roll in exchange for an upfront cost." If the casino says they charge you $3.50 to play this game, in the long run, you guys will break even. If the casino says they want to charge $4 to play this game, in the long run, they're going to collect 50 cents per roll, because they're going to collect $4 to play the game, and they're going to pay out $3.50 in expected value. This is where expected value plays a role in profitability. Let's go ahead and elaborate on expected value to incorporate options and volatility. The great thing about buying options is that you're buying a one-way bet. In the case of a call, you get all the profits above the strike price, and you don't lose more than just your premium below the strike price. Let's see how volatility affects this value of an option. Let's look at a simple example where the underlying is $100 and we're looking at a call with a strike price of $100. Let's further simplify and say by the option's expiration, this underlying can have one of five values. There's a 20% chance the underlying is at $60, a 20% chance it's at $80, a 20% chance it's at $100, a 20% chance it's at $120, and a 20% chance it's at $140. Taking all this together and ignoring the effect of interest rates, let's calculate the expected value of this option. If the underlying is at $60, the option will expire worthless. At $80, it will expire worthless. At $100, it will expire worthless. At $120, the option will expire with $20 of intrinsic value. At $140, the option will expire with $40 of intrinsic value. So the expected value of this option, which is the probability weighted of the outcomes, is going to be $12. Now, let's increase volatility and see how that impacts the expected value of this theoretical call option. Let's say at expiration, the underlying has five different potential values. It has a 20% chance of being worth $20. It has a 20% chance of being worth $60, 20% chance of $100, 20% chance of $140, and 20% chance of $180. Now, probability adjusted, this expected value for this theoretical call option is now $24. You see, when you increase the range of the distribution of final values, you increase the value of one-way bets, which means you increase the value of options. This is why we say buying options is long volatility. If the volatility increases, the expected value of the option will also increase. I hope you can now see how expected value is the foundation of theoretical pricing for options. And it's the foundation of profitability for many businesses, including options trading. I hope this video was helpful. Until next time, find edge, capture alpha, and slang size.